What makes this Sierra HD more powerful than Ford Super Duty?
Battle with cancer, how she's learned to deal with the heartache and suffering head on. Elizabeth Edwards, primetime exclusive on Larry King Live, Wednesday night, 9 Eastern on CNN.
Okay, we're back with our panel. A couple of other issues. The Senate Armed Services Committee opens confirmation hearings for General Petraeus to replace General McChrystal. Will that be pro forma as well, James?
Of course it is. Who's going to vote against General Petraeus? I mean, my God, won't they just send a man over there?
We love Petraeus.
Yeah, whatever. I mean, you're talking about a waste of time. That's a waste of time. I guess
that's
have to air out an Afghan policy and a lack of it or something, but of course he's going to be confirmed. Hey, what?
Dana, the new USA Today Gallup poll shows 53% of America approve the firing of McChrystal, 30% disapprove, the rest don't have any opinion. McChrystal told the Army today he's going to retire. What'd you make of it all, Dana?
Oh, goodness. I talked about this at length on air and online as well. He should have, I think, resigned or stepped down. I do believe that there's protocol that you follow within the military, but I also think that if the administration had perhaps maybe been stepping to a little bit more, he would not have felt the need to fall on his sword, as it were, in Rolling Stone, because this is a man, by the way. Let's not forget that this is a guy who was so unbelievably well-trained. He's not just going to forget whom he's speaking with when discussing something with a Rolling Stone reporter. I think it was absolutely purposeful. He did what he did in order to bring greater attention to Afghanistan and get a little bit more action with it. Before then, the president had hardly met with the guy. He met with him twice, and the second time was over this. So, I mean, yeah.
Stephanie,
I mean,
he and the president were in agreement on Afghanistan policy.
Yes, so that's why I was trying to parse everything Dana just said. You know, that's certainly not how you do it then. If you disagree with strategy, you don't go drinking with a Rolling Stone reporter in a bar and get all chatty. The strategy is the same. They agree on the strategy. This was obviously clearly insubordination. I would have given anything to be a fly on the wall for that meeting, Larry. Say it with me. Awkward. I hope he just took his resignation and just sat there for 20 minutes just staring at him.
Penn, what did you make of it, my libertarian friend? I guess the general could have said anything, right? brought his Uzi into the meeting and said whatever he wanted.
He could say anything he wanted and then get fired. I'm fine with firing him. It's easy to do that. But, you know, I was too young to go into the Vietnam War, but I did pay attention to it. And I would have given anything during the Vietnam War for one general to tell the truth about anything. Even if it was just trashing people in a bar, one little bit of truth would have been nice. What I find disturbing is that McChrystal and Obama agree about the war completely, and that is that the war will go on forever and kill a lot of people and cost a lot of money and can't possibly be won. They both seem to agree on that 100%, and that's what we're doing, and it's really a bad thing. But of course the president can fire him, and of course the president can put anybody he wants and put anybody in the Supreme Court. He's the president. I don't agree with him, but I don't have a vote in this.
Well, he is beholden to the
James, how long does this war go? This war is longer than Vietnam now.
Oh, God, man. You know, but you asked me about what is West Virginia going to do and how long is this war going to go on? That's way above my pay grade. But it depends, no irony here. I agree with almost everything that you just said. And look, the tragedy is in Afghanistan is what we're 9 years into this thing. And man, honestly, I hope I'm wrong, but I don't see a way out anytime soon. It's bad. I hope I'm wrong.
People.
I pray I'm wrong.
We shouldn't be killing.
Right.
Dana, do you see an end game?
Well, I think Petraeus is one of the first smart decisions that this administration has made when it comes to Afghanistan, because Petraeus was the guy who, interestingly enough, the betray us stuff was scrubbed from Move On, and now all the people who hated him are treating him like he's prom queen. But no, I think that this was a good decision getting this guy in, because he's going to go in, get the job done with and minimize casualties, get in there and get it done. That's what he's going to do.
We don't know what the job is. We have no idea what the job is. There's no job to get done. There's just killing people and wasting money.
We're not killing people.
Yeah, we double down on the Bush strategy.
We're not
that's
just
never
going,
smart.
We're not just like going over there with people were talking about Uzis and just taking people out. It's strategy.
We're killing people and dying.
Larry, I hate it when I come on the show and get flanked on the left by Penn Jillette. But,
well, yeah, stop the war. Just stop it.
No,
don't
I understand your point that what
it's
is
a simple
strategy,
point.
But, you know, when people say, oh, he's breaking campaign promises. No, this is what he can't
do. No, he's keeping the campaign promises.
He said he was going to finish the job in Afghanistan. He said Iraq was the wrong war and he was going to
promised
the war.
It.
Now, I'm willing to give him the benefit of the doubt on how we do that and how we get out. I think it's above my, if it's above James Carville's pay grade, it's way above my pay grade.
Well, now how does it?
I can tell you one thing.
So my country, right or wrong, is your point on this? Okay.
Right.
I'm behind this president. That's my point.
That's your point.
Now I tell you what. This strategy. We behind Karzai. We depend on Karzai. There's no way. Karzai is fundamentally corrupt. There's something I do know a little bit about. And I'm sorry. I mean, he might be there, but the idea that this guy is going to help us get out of there is ludicrous.
Ludicrous.
Dana, what's the end game as you see it? How will it end?
How will it end? I can tell you how I would like for it to end. I think Petraeus is going to get us in and get us out. Finish the job, get out. Make sure that they have a stable government. We have people over there that are voting now. Women are being freed. And I think that's, you know, you don't have any progress without struggle sometimes. And I'm glad that we didn't turn a blind eye to a lot of the travesty over there. As a woman, I can say that. But I like Petraeus going in there, doing the job, getting out. Bottom line. I can't tell you what's going to happen.
Here's
I can tell you what
plan.
I would like to see happen.
I hope you're
Here's
right.
Here's my plan. As a woman, I say we airlift anything with a vagina out of Afghanistan, Larry, and just leave it at that.
How about anybody that wants to
but
leave?
But then I feel bad
out,
for the
move
men.
Move over here. Anybody.
There'd be a
Do
lot
anything
of people
to stop killing
willing
people.
To greet the plane.
Stop killing
Okay.
people.
How long do we can't do anything about Karzai. He was elected, right, James? I mean, you're dealing with an elected leader.
I think that there was a dispute, and I think some people thought that we could deal with him. I think sometimes you got to go around him. But this guy, I'll promise you, is fundamentally corrupt. And as long as we're stuck with him, we're not going to do very much over there, I don't think. Not at all. And look, you know, the president doubled down. He doubled down on the Bush strategy. It's not working so far, but, you know, who knows? Maybe General Petraeus will think of something. God knows, I know I would vote for him and, you know, hope he comes up. So I wish to take General McChrystal would come to Louisiana and head up the state coordination of the oil spill. I think this is a guy who needs to change his view in history. I think he can come down here. I think he's a competent guy who just talked too much, and I think he's got a lot to offer this country. And General McChrystal, if you listen to this, come on down here and we can put you to work and you can help a lot of people. I think you're a talented, brave guy.
I'm agreeing with James on a lot today. A lot.
And we'll even let you talk to the press. No, I'm serious. We should do it. I told the governor's office. I called the governor's office and said, y'all ought to have him and head the state coordination. I think this guy, as opposed to going work for defense contractors and schlepping around the Pentagon, like a lot of these retired generals do, he ought to come down here people would have a lot of confidence in him. Guy made a mistake. He ran his mouth to the press too much. We've all done that. There's no difference. Okay,
listen,
can't tell you how many times I've done that.
I've been flanked on the right by Penn Jillette and flanked on the left by James Carville, and I need to go home now.
You're tonight's moderate.
Okay.
Thank you all That's very it. Much, I think.
Okay.
James
Thank
Carville,
you.
Dana Loesch, Stephanie Miller, and Penn Jillette. And Penn, next time, be a little opinionated. He's straddling the middle road here. Don't work.
I'm doing my best, Larry.
Okay. A little boy.